Welcome back to our conduit series. It's been requested that we do a back of bend to back of bend at a specific measurement.
Okay, well, luck would have it, I made this one and it's to exact measurements. So there we go, we're done.
Did you not do a video for that one then, Gary?
No, I didn't record it. Was I expected to record it?
Yeah, well, we didn't have to do this one then.
Okay, so I'd like to challenge Jake in this series of videos on conduit. And if you haven't seen the series, I'll leave a link to those in the description so you can go through the playlist. Now, in this video, I would like you to replicate what I did. So I've already done the hard work for you. I've cut the conduit at 800mm long and I've put a thread on one end. And what I want you to do is from the back of the bend to the end of the conduit, that to be 200mm. Is that a video we've already done?
That is, yep.
So we've already shown that as a separate technique as well as threading the conduit. The new technique for this video wants the back of the conduit to the back of the conduit to be 300mm. Okay, so that's what we've been requested. And then from here to here, you'll need to cut and fabricate whatever conduit's left over so you perfectly match the one that I've done.
Let's do it.
You're up for the challenge. We love to challenge Jake in this series of videos. Some other questions we'd like to answer at this stage was, we were asked what type of conduit were we using? The conduit is from MetPro, along with our boxes as well. I think I've stalled enough time now. It's time to see Jake, if he can, do back-to-back bend to match mine identically.
Let's go. So as you asked, Gary, the first bend is going to be 200 to the back of the bend. So I'm going to measure from the end of this piece of conduit here to 200 there.
Okay, take it over to the conduit bending machine, and this is where we use that scrap piece of conduit, is that right, in the set square?
That's right, as we've seen in a previous video.
Nice bits of Tipex on there. Again, that video is worth checking out. So you're in through to the stop. Now it's important we get this line in the right place as we saw previously. And it's the 200mm mark, obviously, that's gone into the conduit bending machine. Effectively, we're bending the waste, aren't we?
That's right, yeah. So scrap piece of conduit in, set square against it, so we're at the same angle as the conduit.
Okay, yeah. So that's probably a fraction in, so you're going to just pull that back out. So that line there is going to measure and be lined up with the back of the conduit, is it?
That's right, yeah.
So as we look there, it's probably a little bit too far out, is that right? Yeah. We'll go in a back fraction in a further. Touch. You happy with that?
Yep.
Okay, so that's going to be your first bend. Oh, hang on, let's see if these little Tipex marks come in handy. So I'm going to pull it down until... Oh!
There we go.
So you've lined that Tipex mark up with that and you think that might be somewhere very close to 90 degrees.
Yeah, should be there with that.
Let's have a look then. Move my expert piece of conduit out of the way. Yeah, there it is. And is this another case of using the set square?
That's right, yep. So set square against there, and look at that, we're bang on.
Tipex coming handy. Tipex mark, brilliant. Okay, so that's the first bend up.
That's right, so we're then going to measure, as you said, 300 from the back of this bend to our next mark.
We're going to use the scrap piece of conduit there as a sort of datum line, yeah. So this is 300. I like that, using that scrap piece of conduit to get that 300 mark. Important you take your time also getting the right place, and you know, that sort of check twice. Okay, so that's 300. Which bit goes into the conduit bending machine?
So we're going to go this end in first, the end we've measured from.
Okay, because that end is correct, isn't it? So the correct bit goes in first. Okay. Same technique again, is it?
Same process again, yep.
So that scrap piece of conduit, set square, and line the two together. Okay. You're learning quickly. The hardest thing is actually getting the cameraman out of the way, isn't it? You're actually doing the bend. So there we go. So we're lining them up. So I'll just bring it in and have a look. Fraction further in. There we go. I think that's the one. And now it's important, isn't it, that we get this in the right position, isn't it?
That's right, yep. We don't want that twisted when we're done.
So we're going to come straight down there.
Yep. Okay. Ready to bend.
You can bend again. Hopefully you're all commenting how many pieces of scrap conduit are in the background. That's all the other attempts we've obviously had. And again, you're going for my white line?
That's right.
I think you'll fall in love with that, isn't
you?
Yeah,
we are.
It's a good little technique. So, yeah, you there? Okay, let's try it against the wall. See if we've got that to start with parallel with each other.
Okay, Look at that.
I'd just like to say no fee for the Tippex tip. You can all have that one for free from me. So now it's down to measurement though, is it? Is this going to be back to back 300? Are you going to use the, maybe spin it around, use the trunking as a datum line? Yeah, okay. No cheating here. I've got it slightly lifted as well. We will show a technique to bring that slight lift down. What have we got? You're hiding it. That looks smack on. Is that 300?
Yep.
Brilliant. Okay. So we're just going to bring that slightly down, yeah? So we're going to use a technique just to bring that lift down. Okay, so it doesn't quite sit right, so we're just going to obviously bring that down. So do you want to show me the technique for that?
Yep, so it's twisted just slightly, Gary, so we can take that out. It's not a problem. Put it in.
And then you're just lifting.
Just give it a little twist.
By lifting this one up, you pull this one down,
that's
is that right?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see if we can get it laying flat. There's no rock now, is there?
Much better now, yep.
Yeah.
So we're then going to cut this end at 300, as you said, from the back of this bend here.
So if you bring my conduit in, you'll be able to use it as a template, won't you? So just to confirm what I had with mine, so these should sit beautifully on top of each other.
Which they do.
Which they do. And now you can make your measurement at the end of the conduit here.
Yep.
Which we think is about 300, don't
That's we? Right, yep.
Making it look incredibly easy. Obviously I did on my go as well. I made it look incredibly easy. I wished I'd recorded it now. So it's just a case of now cutting and threading that end.
That's right, we'll get that in the vise and cut that.
See how square your end is. Well, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's going to give it a rub anyhow.
Get this little file anyway. So we can now thread that, Gary.
Okay.
So my stocks and dies.
As we showed before, we was going dry to start with to get it to bite on, don't we, with our 20mm stocks and dies.
That's right, yeah. And as we've seen in a previous video, foot on the conduit bender. Just apply forward pressure at first to get it biting.
Yeah.
That's on.
Anyone watching this from a training point of view, you'll probably be amazed how well that bit, but these are brand new stocks and dies, aren't they? So we've got that as a little bit of an advantage. And now you're going to bring your cutting compound in, is that right?
That's right.
Not going to use that tallow that we looked at. That was it beef dripping,
beef
wasn't
dripping,
it?
Yeah, that's right.
So now we're going to thread this one up. Looking good though. So this is about three or four or so turns, and then we go back again, don't we, for that swarf,
That's
don't
right,
we?
Yeah.
So we can just drop that swarf out, and you may see little bits of that gone. We've done a separate video on just how to thread steel conduit. So this is just following on from that. Yeah, you can see the swarf just dropping out there. And that swarf, if it stayed in there, would create a bad thread when it would actually break the thread. So we're not wanting to do that. So we go. And how many threads, just remind me, how many you like hanging out the back?
So I like to see two or three poking through.
Which means we're about halfway through a coupler, aren't we?
That's right. Happy there.
Yeah, okay. And then just a little bit of reaming, and then you've done.
That's it.
Yeah, I think I'll give you a strong 5 out of 10 for this at the minute. So it's just a case now.
So as you say, Gary, conduit reamer, all round file.
Okay, we're going in with a round file. And that's you're done. A little bit of a wipe up, I suppose, get rid of the excess.
That's it.
Yeah. I'll have a closer inspection, I think. My plan seems to have been foiled. I was hoping to use two couplers to join these two pieces of conduit together, and it doesn't look as if I'm going to be able to.
Well, Gary, you look like you've never done any running before, so I'm going to show you. In the next video, I'm going to teach Gary how to do a running coupler. so we can join these two pieces together.
Okay, if we're still talking when we return in the next video, Jake's going to show me how to do a bit of running. But as always, we're interested in your feedback. Please leave them in the comments below. And as always, Jake's going to get back to all of them. Thank you.